Watch my camera on the ground. Watch my camera.
One cheer.
I know. It's been an exciting event here so far. We really appreciate that you, of course, chose to come into this workshop. We're really excited to share with you these techniques that we've been testing and proving for months now. So we know they work with a lot of different people, and we really wanted to share that with you so that you can just come out of here with some solid steps for your team to take away. Because it's not just about you, it's also about being able to effectively train your team on how to actually develop their confidence and structure and know what to do in their business every day, right? How many of you are sitting by someone right now or close to someone that you don't know?
Not
turn around and introduce yourself right now.
Hey, Chris, how are you doing?
Yeah.
Hey, Deb, how are you doing?
It's a good show.
You know why? Because we are one team, Team Beachbody. We've got some amazing stuff to share with you here today so that you can go back and share it with your team. We are connected, one team. Now you're going to go back and share this great training, this system, this template, this structure with your team. So we're excited to be here with you. So our title of the program, of course, is Developing Confidence and Structure for Measurable Results. And realistically, if we're going to just basically boil it down to the most effective skills that you really need to have in your belly when you're growing your business, and what your team always needs to have in their belly. Because we know we can do so many different things. I mean, you can do home parties, fit clubs, challenge groups, but the real core principles of growing your business to create residual income, which that's what many of our goals are, aside from, of course, helping people, helping ourselves, but really what it comes down to, being in a business like this where this can replace your income, where you can be here and be making money. Like, I didn't even check to see how much money I made on Thursday. Did you?
No,
I actually did not. Now that you say that. Oh my gosh, for the first time ever, she always sends me a text. Oh my gosh, the biggest check ever.
I do.
Like every week. So I made the biggest check ever. But that's actually a good sign. Like here we are, we're away, and we made money. And yep. We don't even know it, because that's residual income structure. Yep. And the only way to create residual income, though, is to build a strong team. Because you, of course, can be focusing on commissionable sales, but that is what it's totally dependent on you, on sales. So you have to really be focusing on that. But longevity, for this to be your solid like placement for money coming in when you're not even working it, residual income, that's what we're going to teach you how to build for today. We'll move past our headshots. This clicker's not working right now. Well, that's good. There. I grabbed my lip gloss as the clicker when I was about to come out. I was like, oh, that's my lip gloss. That does not work. There we go. All right, so many of the times, obviously, as we've been growing in this business, I've been doing it now for 4 years, and in 4 years of being in this business, a lot of the processes that I've done, I'm constantly changing. I was not a network marketer before getting involved in this. I used to work in medical sales and applications. I used to take people's x-rays, or I'd teach them how to use the equipment. Oh, and I'm also a fitness instructor. That was my primary jobs that I used to do, as well as I used to work for Chalene Johnson's company. I'm kind of a workaholic a little bit. But the main concepts that in all of the time that I've been building this business, once I got started, is no matter what process we were following, we knew that that was going to change because it worked for that moment in our business. It worked for that maturity that we were in our business. So when I first got started, there were no game plans or coach training academies. There was nothing. And the wheel, of course, had to be created. I, of course, hired Craig Holiday to help me and my team to be able to figure out what we should be actually doing every day in a business like this. And Craig was the one who shared with us, and so I know that lots of you know Craig as well. Craig was the one that shared with us the thought that the people that succeed in this business are the ones that get in and don't quit. They get in and don't quit. I'm not going anywhere, are you?
No.
I love Mike Ryan, because Mike Ryan always says you have to pry my dead hands off this business. And that's how I feel too. As Craig said, the ones who win get in, they just don't quit. They build for longevity. We're building for the future. Kind of like being a parent or a teacher. We're doing stuff right now and laying a foundation piece by piece with patience, with credibility, ethically, with character, with integrity. We're doing that piece by piece. So for the long term, for longevity, when we're still here 10 years from now, we all have an amazing business to share and to talk about.
And then what it really boils down to is, you know that there's so many systems out there, there's so many plans, and people are constantly looking for something tactile. They just want to know, they want a check-in point, so that they know that what I'm doing is actually going to produce results. And stop trying to wonder and figure out, is this exactly what I'm supposed to be doing? Is that going to get me, bless you, to do whatever I want to, to get to make my business grow? People need something that they need to hold on to, a checkpoint. We've had the game plan. The game plan is a great, solid structure system. I do not tell my coaches to make sure that they go do that immediately, like go start doing a meeting once a week. I don't have my coaches do that once a week. No. You follow things loosely as a guideline. But overall, no matter what system you're following, especially if you walk out of here and you start following this process of how to share the business with people, to effectively present the business and follow up with them, that's just a system. What is the real meat of how we're going to grow in this business is that you stay inspiring, you stay motivating people, you stay passionate about helping people just live a better, healthy, and happy life.
Yeah.
That's your mission. This is just kind of the groundwork belly of what we're going to focus on. And most of the time when people get started in this business, they really start searching. They start trying to figure out what other people are doing because they don't know exactly what to do. How many of you get those emails out there where you get a coach that will follow up or contact you and say, hey, I'm a new coach. I just got started. I don't know what to do. Can you tell me what to do because you're successful? Anybody get those emails? Okay. Well, first of all, you can't just say, well, this is my plan. Just do this, this, and this, and here you go. It's like, who's got the weight loss pill? Please give it to me. Hello. There is no weight loss pill. We know there is no secret of success. It's a matter of mostly just building that consistency and confidence in yourself. And if you try to skip basic steps in your business and try to just try everything. Because you find some of your coaches will come to you and say, well, I've been watching Josh Spencer, and I've been watching Lindsay Matway, and I've been watching Barbie Decker, I've been watching Hillary Kelly, and those guys are all doing this, this, and this, and this, and this. Shouldn't we all be doing this, or I'm going to try that? Mm-hmm. If you try to do what everybody else is doing, you're not going to succeed. Do where you should be in your business. Because I'm 4 years old in this business. What my activity that I do every day is not what a coach should be doing every day. What is not what an Emerald coach should be doing every day. Is not what a Ruby coach should be doing every day. It's completely different. I've got a huge downline that I'm responsible for. I've got a lot of personal sponsor coaches that I'm responsible for. But I've also got my own brand, my own business that I'm responsible for. My life is different than what a normal coach getting started should do. So be simple. Would you say?
And hopefully in this training, we're going to teach you some of the steps that you can do so you won't skip those basic steps. Because we all lead very, very busy lives. And because we're so busy, sometimes we're consumed with being busy but not productive. Because it feels good to be busy. We're working our business, but we're not productive. So rather than skipping some steps so that we continually just feel busy but aren't as productive, this system should help you be busy and productive.
So realistically, what this is really boiling it down to is, we know that, again, a lot of people just want to have something to check back with, a reference manual, a reference point. So you're going to find in this training here that we just really want to keep it super simple. And you probably already know this, and you're going to go, no, duh, I already know this. It's just it took her to say it out loud to me for me to know how to do this. And that's what we're going to do, is we're just going to paint that path for you of exactly how to set up an appointment to get someone to look at this business and then follow up and hopefully get them to do what you want them to do for their goal. Mm-hmm. That's what our goal is here for this training here. And we want to keep it super simple. And we know there's so many other areas that you can be growing in your business. What we're just focusing on is one small little niche. So we're not saying this is the perfect end-all be-all thing that you should be doing. Take this with a grain of salt, just like everything you learn out there. But this is just one solid structure system. If you can nail for yourself and you can nail and teach your team is going to grow. I promise you. I will guarantee you that because I've got proof coming up to show you how your team is going to grow once you start to implement this system. So the first thing we want to talk about is what?
protocol. We're going to talk about protocol. We're going to talk about the activities that you should do each day to move your business forward each day. Because again, it's not just about being busy, it's about being productive. So we need to be working on something every day that moves our business forward. Does that mean that we need to work our Beachbody business 8 hours a day every day? No, but we need to do stuff that moves our business forward every single day. So we're going to teach you some structure, some templates, some protocol to help you move your business forward every single day. We're going to talk about duplication, because the key to this business is what?
Duplication.
Duplication. When you leave here tomorrow, what do you have to do?
Share.
Yes, you have to share. You absolutely have to share. You've got to go home and share with your team. If you don't have a team yet, you share with yourself over and over again. But you've got to go home and share this, because it doesn't matter what we know. It only matters what we share. You have to share. You need a reference point. You need a place for the coaches, for your team to come back to, a touchstone. And you've got lots of different options for that. You might have a printed manual. I like things in my hand. As an English teacher, so you might have a printed manual. Some of your coaches might like that as well. You might have a website. You might have a team Facebook page. Whatever it is, a place for them to come and connect and talk, ask questions that feels a little bit more intimate and gives them a reference point, a check-in spot. But last, most importantly, we want to help you develop.
The biggest and strongest step that what you're going to take away from this is not the step-by-step process that we'll teach you, but mostly if you can just bury this big word in your belly, seriously, big things are going to change for you. Because what we've found in the growth of both of us doing this business, we've been doing this business for 4 years exactly, and we started in the same time, and the success for people really comes down to confidence. Think about it. In your life now, in something that you're not successful with, you don't have confidence in, you don't really push hard, you don't really talk much about, you kind of recede a little bit. My husband and I, we tried snowboarding about a year ago. Oh boy. I'm a skier. And when we first met back in 2002, we went skiing one time, and he tried snowboarding then, and he fell so many times, he said, never again. So then for like 8 years, we never skied again. And we lived in New York at the time. And so then we finally went snowboarding out in Utah. And I took lessons from the Australian. So I was like, I'm going to learn this. These guys know what they're talking about. They come here. Okay. And seriously, we went back home to New York, and I was willing a helicopter to get me off that mountain so hard, because I was like, where are my skis? I just want my skis. This snowboard is not good. I was not successful. I'm not confident in that. And the confidence shows through in the board, because I kept falling. Every time I hit the toe edge, I'd like bite it. So it's a matter of, if you're not confident in what you're doing, or having confidence in what you're doing, you're not going to do it. I wanted to ski. That's it. I don't know if I'm going to go back to snowboarding. I don't know. But that's where it comes down in this business. If you can build confidence in having better conversations with people and know how that conversation should go, what you should say and when you should say it, you're going to feel good and you're going to do it more often. Because isn't that the key of growth in this business? Doing it more often. You can't just talk to a couple people and hope and cross and fingers and toes and everything that they're going to join. They're not. Every person I talk to about the business, I really don't even know or care sometimes if they're going to sign up. I just talk to so many people. I keep laying so much groundwork and breadcrumbs out there that eventually when they're ready, they'll sign up. I just keep doing it over and over again, because I'm never going to convince someone to do this business, ever. So if you can walk away with stronger confidence yourself, and if you could teach this to your team that they feel like, oh my gosh, I got this to connect with, it's going to work, that's where your team is going to grow, because they're going to feel anchored. Mm-hmm. It's like an anchor, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. All right, so the basics of your business, the three basic principles. We know there's so many different areas you could be focusing on, but we know that in this aspect of how can you build residual income like we were talking about, it boils down to these three principles. Exposure and sharing, presentation and follow-up. What has Carl Bedeker been saying to us that is the number one crucial behavior that we have to do? Invite, invite, invite. Exposure, sharing. It's just a different word for what we need to be doing. We have to invite. Do you love this business?
Woo!
That was weak sauce, and you know it. Do you love this business?
Woo!
Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Or you wouldn't be here. So it's almost an obligation for us to share it. It should be coming out of us. We're so passionate about it. It's that amazing. It's changed our life that much. So we're on a course for it to change our life. All we're doing is sharing that with people. We're just inviting people to experience. How can we keep this to ourselves? It's like Shakeology. Like, I got to tell everyone about it. How can I keep this to myself? It's too awesome. So that's what we're doing. We're inviting. We're presenting the business or the product to people, because how can they know about it unless we tell them about it? And then the key is we're following up. Because we can talk to a lot of people, but if we don't get back to them, it's not going to matter. And guess what? They're probably not going to get back to you. They're waiting for you to contact them. So the key is the follow-up at the end of that.
Well, these are supposed to be yours, but okay. Okay, so the presentation. So when you're sharing your presentation for the business, really find what you feel is going to connect with you for the most part. Always have a solid webinar training that you always were going to direct people to, as well as an audio recording, or maybe a phone call with a certain coach that you want them to talk to. But it's called a third-party tool that you always make sure that you at least know exactly where you're going to send someone to. You don't need to fumble in your brain of where you're going to send someone to. Now, for me, of course, my team is Platinum Presenters, and I've created a lot of tools. Created a lot of tools for them. So we hold weekly webinars where a lot of our Diamond, Star Diamond coaches run those trainings and the new coach training calls, as well as there's a recorded webinar presentation housed on my website that I can always just direct someone to 24/7 to watch. Mm-hmm. And there's also a 15-minute audio on my website that if someone just wants to drive in their car and listen to an audio, they can send that person that phone number to listen to get their interest piqued, to look a little further. That's our goal. You don't want to teach someone this business, do you?
No.
You just want to pique their interest of, maybe I should check that out. That's it. You don't need to name drop or throw any money figures out there, or this is what we're doing, this is what that tastes like, that's what this is coming out, this is this, because you're just confusing them. You're talking them out of even looking at it. So just really focus on a small, simple step so that they can look at it and decide for themselves. Mm-hmm. And the follow-up? We're teaching you how to do a follow-up.
Afterwards, the setting the appointments and making sure that you are talking with them. As I said before, if you are waiting for them to get back with you, they're not, because guess what? You want them. You have something to share with them. So you need to make sure that you're setting that appointment, you're getting back with them, you're staying connected with them, so that you can share the business, share the project. Keep them in your circle. Keep them in your network. You want them to have reasons to stay connected with you, and that's that follow-up. And that's the key to the success, is making sure that you're staying connected with them, you're staying engaged with them, and keeping them in that circle, and nailing those follow-ups after you've talked to them.
Well, that's what it's really about. It's just all about relationships.
It is.
Again, it's not about what money you're going to make, what Shakeology you're going to sell, what coach you're going to sign up. It's not that at all. Because if you just focus on those numbers solely, like people are just numbers or dollar signs to you, you will not have success.
Yep.
The reason why Julie is as successful as she is, or other coaches like Josh Spencer or Monica Gray or Janelle Summer, of those coaches are super successful because they put relationships first. They're not focusing on that dollar sign and that number. And that's where we really need to focus on, and we're going to do this in the end part of the of this presentation, of how to have better conversations, because it's not just about putting the business in front of someone. We'll teach you that. But we're also going to teach you how to have better conversations so that you can build better relationships and have more effective communication. Because if you can improve your communication skills, if you can have better face-to-face conversations with people, you're going to grow fast. That is the key. So would you say that's the truth? That the secret to success is
communication.
It is.
It's absolutely communication.
There you go.
That's how you develop your relationship, and that's how you develop trust. Relationship, trust, team. So it's communication skills that we hope to share with you today, as well as our system and you can have that to take back with you. And again, just allowing that passion that you have for the business to come out, and remembering that we have something so amazing in our hands. Let that fuel your confidence, so that when you're talking to someone, you're not constantly worrying about, what are they thinking about me? Am I wearing something? What's going on? Mm-mm. Just talking about how amazing this business is, and you will be so confident about it. Those one-on-one conversations that you have will be so much easier. The relationships will come. The trust will come. The team will come.
And that's really what we're focused on, is really just, number one, being sociable first. So if you, when you're having your conversations, and if you constantly have in the back of your mind while you're in that conversation, that blank point of, when can I jump in and tell them about Shakeology, then you're never going to grow. Because if you always have that hidden agenda back there, that relationship, you're not listening to them, you're not hearing what they really are about, you're just so ready to jump in with the Me Toos or Shakeologies or P90X. And that's not what this is. It's just about, have conversation where you can be okay that you'll have many conversations where it goes nowhere. You don't even say the BB word at all. Next thing is, you, of course, we're going to be starting with whys and how. What do you do? Asking them questions in your conversations. Be inquisitive, because that's going to help you with communicating more and less about yourself. And finally, let me ask you this quickly first. How many of you sit in your house all day long and don't go anywhere?
Someone has to
know that's not true. So when you're out and about in your day, the grocery store, the bank, dropping your children off, running around, are you out and talking to people? Man, I sure hope so, because that's what being sociable is. It's not going out with the intent to sell Shakeology. When someone says to me, well, I can't do that because I have to sell, thank goodness, because I don't want you if you sell. I want you, if you're sharing, and if you're talking to people and you're being social to people and you're asking the whys and the whats and not worrying about what you're going to say and sharing your story, that you're asking what their story is. And then as you get into the conversation with them, adjusting to their mannerisms and to their styles, you can probably tell that Christine and I are similar personality styles. We're kind of loud. We're kind of intense. we're crazy sometimes. We're just kind of out there. Not everyone is. Not everyone is like that. So if I'm speaking with someone and I can tell, and I'm, because I'm paying attention and you're paying attention to that person with whom you're having a conversation, that our loud personality is not resonating with them, what do we need to do? We need to tone it down a little bit. Does it mean I don't have to be me?
No.
No, I just need to turn the volume down just a little bit. Because the more I can relate to their personality style, their mannerisms, how they're speaking, what's that going to improve between the two of us? Our communication, our relationship is going to grow. If I'm only concerned about when can I talk about TurboFire or Shakeology, I'm only concerned about my story and not paying attention to that person with whom I'm speaking, I'll never pay attention to their mannerisms and their style, and I might have great information, but I'm not saying it in a way that resonates with them. So it doesn't matter how great my information is, because they're not hearing it. So pay attention to what they're, how they're talking, how they're speaking, and adjust your mannerisms to fit that as well. Don't not be you. Just tweak it a little bit so that they hear what you're saying. Because what we have to say is so great. It's so great. And that actually, you know, carries over into learning about different personality styles. So yeah, you can adjust it while you're having your conversation. But if you really want to develop and have better conversations with people, really try to dive and educate yourself further on learning what types of different personalities there are out there. And one of the books that we initially read a couple years ago was called Personality Plus. And that one dives into kind of four categories of personality types. And I know some of you are following Dani Johnson, and she talks about that in Gems as well. But the whole, doesn't matter who you're following, but if you can understand what type of information that personality type wants to hear, then when you have your conversations, you know what to say to pique their interest. Because you asked it before, what type of personality am I?
I know what you are. Do you guys know?
Do you guys know? What? Sapphire?
Okay.
Clerk?
Sanguine.
He said it. Yes. That's not it, actually.
I thought it was just... Is it just choleric?
I'm choleric!
Oh. Yes. Strong. Strongly choleric. Yes. Which means, and if you don't know anything about personalities, it's just one of those, black, white people, tell me what to do, just get it done, move on, let's go, you know, like, just move forward. And a lot of the times, if I'm talking to someone who is as known as a sanguine, which is someone who just wants to know, well, how am I going to feel? You know, what's this feely, touchy-feely, happy, joy aspect? Stop touching your boobie. Not boobie, boobie. Boom. Boom, excitement. Woo! Anyway, encouragement. So with that, we need to adjust when I'm having conversations. And the only way I'm going to know what her personality is by the questions I'm asking her. So when I ask her a question and the way she responds to that and the type of answer she gives me, I can see where she's going, and then I can feed my questions a little bit better. So we're not going to focus on this any longer because I really want you to just go figure that out on your own. Let's move on. Go figure that out. Yeah, that's just a plan. Just a tidbit. Okay, so the real core principles of growth in your business. If you want residual income, if you want to go on vacation and not have to work, if you want to be locked away in a cruise, who was on a cruise last year in Success Club? We were locked away, couldn't talk to anybody, we couldn't find anyone on the ship because we couldn't text anyone, nothing. But we were locked away for a week and we couldn't do anything with our business unless you probably paid a ton of money. But we went away for a week and we still made money when we got back. So that's what residual income is. And the only way to really create that is by building a team. A team of people building a team of people building a team of people. Once you keep really doing that and you focus on the general mission of our company, you're going to have success. So the core principles that we're going to really focus on right now is a general guideline. Is keeping it super simple. So keep it simple, silly.
Well, super simple.
Sylvester up here. So keeping it simple. Too many times people just talk way too much. Right? My sister, she talks all the time and I just keep trying to reel her in. Like she sends me seriously 5-minute voicemails and sometimes I don't even listen to them all because they're too long. And she says the same thing over but just different ways. You know, so I know when I hear it the first time, I know she's going to say it like 3 more times but again in a different way. So the thing is that's what we tend to do in this, is we tend to try to convince someone with how amazing this is. Because you're going to leave here super excited, right? You guys are around so many positive people, the energy is high, you're learning so much great information. You're going to go home, you're going to bombard your person next to you on the plane. You're going to be like, who are going to talk to go to the slot? Like, I need 5 people for July. Like, you're going to be all over the place trying to talk to people, and then all of a sudden, before you know it, because you're so excited, when you're excited about something, you start talking about everything. And then they just came out with this vegan technology, and then what we're going to do is we're going to come out with the beast, and then we're going to come out with this, comments, we're coming out with this, and we're like, well, everything, and this trainer was there, and this trainer was there. It's like you start talking. And that person's like, what? I don't even want to look at what you're talking at. That's it. Stop. Let's keep it simple. Super simple. So when you're putting the business in front of someone, if you just focus on super simple roadmap of how it should go, that's when you're going to have more people signing up. And it really comes down to you just do this over and over and over and over and over again. Lather, rinse, repeat. Do it over. Because as soon as you stop, that's when the train stops. Mm-hmm. And it's hard to get that train going again.
It sure is.
Darren Hardy spoke a couple years,
2 years ago.
2 years ago, uh-huh. Yeah, summit. Mm-hmm. And he used that analogy of, you know, that pumping the well. I mean, we used to go out and get spring water where you had to pump a well. And then as soon as the pump goes forever, then the water's flowing. But as soon as you stop, it's going to slow. And then you got to push hard again to get to go. That's what your coaches do all the time. That's what many of you may have done, is that you started going, you're having good times, and then all of a sudden someone died in your family. And then something else happened in your life. And then you got derailed and you weren't doing what you should be doing all the time to grow your business. And then now you had to like, do it again. If you're consistent, it's going to keep growing no matter what. Every month, making Success Club happens. It does. Because you're laying seeds along the way. You're constantly laying seeds. The only way you're going to be able to make that 5 coach for Carl's mission for July is if you really focus more on being consistent and laying those seeds. And when will the most amount of those people actually sign up to do your challenge or sign up to be a coach or a customer? When will that happen if you do that now? End of June? When will that typically happen? End of July, don't you think? End of July. Because you've been depositing seeds. Mm-hmm. And you can't just say, grow, right? You have to cultivate it.
He's so nice.
You keep making that relationship go. You keep diving into their need, checking in with them. And then when they're ready, most of the times it's usually after a little bit of time. So that's what we really have to think about if you want to make your goal. And this is a system that we're going to have you follow. And if you follow it simply, just when you have those conversations, your conversations when you're putting the business in front of people are going to be so much more successful. They will allow you to sign up more coaches. I promise. I guarantee it. I guarantee it, and I got something to show you that's going to prove it as well.
And this business is fun. Do you love? I mean, I love this business. This business is fun. But are there some moments every once in a while where it's not quite as fun? Every once in a while. Again, as Christine referenced, Darren Hardy said, consistency is doing those unsexy things when nobody else wants to do them, and doing them over and over and over again. So if you follow this system or any system, your structure that you have, and doing it over and over and over again, then it's going to net those seeds that she was talking about in July. Your action items today, we're going to talk about a plan share and a surprise share. A plan share is exactly what it says. You are planning to meet with someone to talk about the business or a product. The two of you, or maybe a group, and you are meeting together, and you all know that the intent of this meeting is to talk about something related to Beachbody. It's an appointment. Just as Christine will reference a little bit later, a hair appointment or a car checkup appointment. You make an appointment, it's planned, everyone there knows what's going on. A surprise share is something that just happens as you're out living your life, opening yourself to life. If I looked in your bag when you went home, your bag that you take out and about with you, do all of you have business cards and Shakeology samples in your bag when you leave your house?
Yes.
You should. And when we were talking about this presentation, one of my coaches posted on our team Facebook page just this week, and it's so, so great and so perfect, I had to share it with you on stage. I'm going to pull it up. Her name is Kay Page, and she has no idea that I'm sharing her story on stage at Summit right now. And she said that she was at a grocery store in the produce section, and she overheard two employees talking about their weight and another girl whose button popped on her pants because she had gained weight. Kind of light and funny conversation. So she said, popping a button is never a good thing, and they all smiled and kind of laughed and moved on. But then she turned her card around and gave her business card to the guy that was making fun of the button popper and said, sorry to eavesdrop, but it's my job to help people with their nutrition and fitness. Can you give this to the gal whose button popped off? I'd love to talk with her if she wants. In the grocery store, she was having a conversation. She was living her life. She was just living her life. Cared enough to share that with someone and had her business card on her. If she hadn't had her business card, that would have been a lost opportunity. How many opportunities are out there every day if we're looking for them? Hundreds and thousands. People need what we have. They need what we have. Keep those business cards and those Shakeology samples handy. You'll run into people all the time with them that you've talked about Shakeology, you haven't had a chance to get them a sample or something. Now you've run into them at dance or the gym or somewhere that you're running your life, and you happen to have that sample, and now you can give it to them. Never leave your home without your business cards and your Shakeology packets, because you never know when these kinds of opportunities are going to happen. You've got to be ready for them, because people need what we have. Well, obviously, since we work with Beachbody, we know that they really value the aspect of testimony. So, for instance, there's so many times I've had people contact me just because they know I'm connected with Shalene as a presenter for her, that they want me to get them in the door to get their workout into Carl so that they could be the next famous person. Yeah, so many people want to be the next famous fitness celeb that doing videos. But the reason why, like Shalene talked about yesterday in session, was that she was able to get the Turbo Jam deal because she had a binder of testimony. That's what Beachbody looks for, is you can't be a success unless you've proven your success, that it works. And that's what we're going to be sharing with you, is this five-step process that we'll share with you on how to actually grow your business and teach your coaches to grow your business. We've been doing already. We've been running these groups called Boot Camp with Platinum Presenters, and what it's been teaching is this core principle we're taking out from that had made their business grow. They learned it in the beginning of the training for 30 days. They were with us for 30 days, and then once they learned it, they really crushed applying it for the rest of the time with us, and when they did that, you're going to see in this video here, to prove this works, that it works. So here we go.
Here we go, maybe. Here we go. So in my first month of boot camp, I sold 5 challenge packs. I've signed 2 coaches. I have 1 getting ready to sign. And my income, my weekly income tripled this week.
To prove that the methods of boot camp work, I picked up the phone. I called people. I emailed people. I texted people. I Facebook people. I singled people out. I didn't just put a broadcast message on Facebook and Twitter. I made Success Club in 30 hours. Keep on reaching for your dreams. Hey, say, I wanna own it. Really pushed me to become more consistent and more disciplined. You know, I love seeing my calendar fill up with appointments and follow-ups. It truly makes you feel so confident in your ability to own your own business.
It's teaching me exactly how to talk to people, how many people I should be talking to, and what I should be saying.
The biggest thing that I have taken away is confidence. It's how to present this business to people without sounding like a salesperson or without scaring them away.
I grew my business 120%. Seriously, 120%.
What I was doing was actually deciding for someone else whether or not this was for them.
Because I consistently had been doing the things that I had learned in boot camp, the 5-step exposure, my coach signups doubled. My customer base has doubled. My confidence is through the roof.
Able to promote myself from emerald to diamond. I actually tripled my income.
And I started to see people who had once shrugged me off kind of take more notice to me, kind of wonder what I was doing and what was different about how I was handling myself. And through that, I actually signed coaches. I sold challenge packs.
I've signed 3 coaches. I have a 4th coach signing today. I hit Success Club 5 in May.
In order to grow a business like this, you have to be able to teach your coaches how to do the same thing that you're doing to grow your business.
Duplication. Until now, I haven't known how to help my team. But now, I feel like a strong and confident leader.
From there, I've taken my leaders and taught them the 5-step process. From that, my business has exploded. So I've been a diamond coach for a while. I've been a star diamond coach for a while, a 1-star diamond coach, and I'm now a 2-star diamond coach.
I will lift you up to your highest heights and make you believe that you can accomplish anything. I've learned that I need to believe in myself as much as I believe in all the people around me.
The biggest piece that I took away is confidence. I've always believed in the business, and I always knew what it took to grow the business, but I was always hesitant at certain times when talking to people about the opportunity of coaching. And going through this boot camp program has given me the confidence to not only believe in the business, but to believe in myself.
My income has been more consistent. I have some weeks doubled and other weeks tripled my normal income because of what I've learned.
I signed up 9 coaches. 9 coaches in 30 days.
Believe it or not, I did sign on 2 coaches. And I was really excited because I was like, wow, I signed on 2 coaches, which I never would have done.
Follow-up is the key to helping walk people through the next step.
I have
have presented this business more times during boot camp than I have the whole time I've been a coach.
That five-step exposure is doable. It's easy. It's natural and organic, where you're talking to people about the business, asking them to look at something, and following up with them in an easy step-by-step process that works.
I've been able to duplicate and pass along to my team leaders.
And using the system to keep yourself as a guideline so that you don't overtalk.
I now believe in myself. I have the confidence to talk to people, to start conversations with people I don't know.
This is the right training for you.
The biggest advice I can give you is to just do it. Just focus.
But it's the control. You demand control of the whole situation. That makes you the boss, that makes you the owner, and that makes all the difference in the way you're going to grow your business.
I love what Meredith said. I didn't notice that last time. I said it's like natural. All right, so basically, if you think of it this way, if you want to sign those five coaches for July, do what we're going to teach you today. If you have no idea what you should be doing every day in your business, like if you wonder, is this the activity I should be doing every day in your business? We're going to share with you exactly the core activity of growth for your business right now. So these slides, of course, are going to be available back in your coach back office. But basically, this is just core activity. This is one small step of what you will be doing in your business. This will build your team. And those people that were on that video, you saw a lot of Star Diamond ranking in there, didn't you? Many of the Star Diamond coaches out there still needed to learn how to fine-tune for themselves as well as their coaches so that they can have success. That's what it's about. Other people having success, not just yourself. It really means, let me teach someone else, because then that always pays you back. So the first step that you're going to do so that you know what you should be doing every day is to, first thing, make a big list. I call this my Big Mac Daddy list. It's the big list that you get where you're collecting. You're doing your brainstorming. You're doing your memory jackers. You're going through where you go throughout your day. You're putting those people's names on your list. All the people. You're going through your address books. You're going through your Facebook. You're trying to remember exactly who it is in your life. Now, this also relates to, for instance, if I just met Julie on the street and I know that her husband has a landscaping business, I'm going to say, hey, I need to get some landscaping done. Can I have your card or your information? I want to get in touch with you to hire your husband. That person's name goes on the list. That's the Mac Daddy list. But there's a separate list that you're going to be working off of. And the people that come to mind may also go on this Big Mac Daddy list. But this third part, your hot list, is the one that you're going to develop weekly. How many of you work in an industry where you have to schedule your appointments? Like, for instance, you have to schedule where you're going to go do some pharmaceutical sales calls, hair appointments, or massage therapy appointments. You have to have appointments so you know what you're doing for that week, where you're going for that week. This is the same thing. It's not any different. This is your business. So why aren't you scheduling your appointments? Why are you leaving your exposures up to chance? That's what she talked about earlier with the planned share and the surprise share. If you leave your exposures up to, maybe I might run into someone today, it's not going to happen. You have to think actively and schedule an appointment to speak with someone every day if you want to grow aggressively. If you don't want to grow aggressively, then don't do it every day. You decide how many in a week's time you want to do, and then you'll know the path of your growth. That's it. So your hot list is the people that you pluck off of your big list and say, I'm going to get to call that person this week, hot list. You, how many that is? That's up to you. That's your first step.
Christina, and you know, they might want to know if that Mac Daddy list, which is such a great name, you should title it that, definitely, will morph as you grow. It's changing because have you ever met someone who says, one of your coaches maybe that says, well, I don't have anyone else on my list. What? Mm-hmm. Go out and do something because there are so many people out there and the list changes. And I was just thinking about that when you were talking earlier because I hadn't thought about some of the moms at my daughter's dance studio. And when I started talking to one or two of them about Shakeology, I got like a circle of 10 now that are now on my big list that weren't there before. The list morphs and changes and grows and it's fluid and you're adding to it all the time. There are so many people out there. Keep it very fluid so that list can grow. Well, that's a good point that you brought up about, like, the moms at the dance studio. So even if you're not just going out, because not everybody goes out, that's the big excuse people say, is I don't go out anywhere, I can't meet anybody. Well, you know people, and people know people. Mm-hmm. So you need to ask. If you're not directly saying, hey, do you want to, you could be going up and saying, hey, do you know someone? Is your friend in fitness? Isn't your friend a personal trainer? You could be asking that person to get you in touch with the other person. Mm-hmm. It's not always the person right in front of you. It could be their connection.
Absolutely.
Your second step is to schedule your goal of shares or exposures that you want to do each day on your calendar. So however you want to work on your calendar, if you are a tactile person and you need to physically write it, or on a dry erase board, or if you're on a smartphone, wherever you are scheduling on your calendar, put it on your calendar. You're making appointments to put the business in front of someone. That's what you're doing. Don't leave it up to chance, because chance doesn't make your business grow. And this is what your calendar would look like. So basically, you just start putting people on. Okay, I'm going to call Jody then, Mike then, Susan then, Dan then. You just start filling up your calendar with your appointments. Now, how do you make those appointments? This is how you're going to make those appointments. So step three is you're going to schedule the connection with them, but on the phone. Okay, here's some rules for you. You follow them if you want or not. I'm going to share with you what I've tested and proved to work. Those people in the video, they listened, they did these little rules, and it works. I tested it the other way, it doesn't work. So here we go. If you go to your list, your hot list, and you send that person an email telling them to check out this business presentation or whatever you want them to look at. As soon as you send the email, so as soon as you hit send, please go get a pen or marker and cross that person off your list. Is a no. They won't. Think of yourself. How many of you have gotten those emails from someone that says, hi, I just got into a business with Mary Kay or Irvine or some other business, and I would love for you to go check out my website. Can you please go here? And what do you immediately do to that email? Thank you. You don't even read all of it, do you? I could get that from my own sister and I'll delete it. Because as soon as it sounds like a script, I'm out. If you get those phone calls, hi, would you like to make more money? Do you hang up or do you go, yes, I do. You hang up. You know. So if you know your nature on how you respond to something, why are you doing it then? And this, it doesn't work. It's human contact. So one of the rules that I have in these five steps exposures that we're going to show you is you need to do it on the phone. The other aspect is that I try to train my new coaches. I could tell Julie to go meet someone at a coffee shop because she's so confident in knowing how to do this. She'll do fine. She knows what to say. But if I have a new coach who's still finding their way, I will never teach them to go meet someone in person to share this business. Because you feel obligated then to fill the time of driving to Starbucks, don't you? So if you made an appointment with someone, you said, I'm going to go meet you at Starbucks, and then you get there, how long is your meeting going to be? 2 minutes? Here it is. See ya. Thanks for coming. No, it's not. You're going to be like, okay, so let's fill the time. Let me tell you all about this. Let me show you all the programs. Let me show you everything. Let me talk about this person. Let me talk about that. You're going to over-talk the situation. You may talk them right out of even looking at it. What we want to teach you here is let's teach a get in, get out. A, hey, you should check it out process. It's just a little bit of a teaser. It's a teaser. That's all you want. Tease them. And then when they go and look at it, they're going to make the decision for themselves. Your follow-up is the key to it all.
And the phone part, I know sometimes can be scary.
Yeah.
To people, we've talked about that. But have you ever gotten an email or a text where you're like, what might they say? What is the tone of that? I can't believe they would say that to me. Because tone is so difficult to convey in an email or a text. But do you have any doubt in your mind right now that this woman is passionate about this business? No, because you hear it in her voice. So when you have, even if it's a quick 2-minute phone call, when you can hear that in someone's voice, there's no mistaking the tone as there might be in an email or a text. You hear that passion and you're drawn into that. And yeah, maybe I will learn a little bit more because, dang, you sound super fired up about it. So maybe I should learn a little bit more.
All right, so how do you get them on the phone? It's hard to just call someone. You're like, I'm not saying just call someone randomly and start to pitch the business to them. I'm not saying that at all. There's actually one step you do need to do before. It's you do actually send them a text or an email. What? Yeah, I thought you just sent that to email. Yes, I'm saying the email now. You can. This, an inquiry. An inquiry is where you're basically just sending them like a one-sentence question to set up the appointment. That's it.
But you do not say, hey, I want to talk to you about the business I'm in. Or I wanted to talk to you about Shakeology. You don't say anything about this. What you do say is you bring up why you thought of them. Mm-hmm. That's it. So if, my next slide is going to give you some examples. If I am talking to someone and they are an instructor, then I might say, this next one coming up. Hey, Jody, I had a quick question about your Zumba classes. Are you free tomorrow for a quick call? Am I going to be talking to her about Zumba? Yes, I will a little bit. I have to. Because this is the reason I'm thinking of her. I'm thinking of her because she teaches Zumba, and people who teach Zumba, they have a huge following because it's super popular. They have a lot of people that will follow them wherever they go, whatever they say, whatever they eat, they'll do what they say. So why not talk to her about that? And I'm going to bring that up to her and tell her, well, you teach this. Don't you have this going on in your life? Don't you have a lot of people that ask you all the time to help them lose weight? Don't you have a lot of people that ask you all the time what they should be eating? What's she going to say? Yeah. Yes, she's got a following. So did I lie? Am I not talking about Zumba? No, I'm bringing up why I thought of her. Because she teaches Zumba. She's got a huge following of people who love her. That's all this business is, bless you. It's about, people are sneezing. It's about people connecting with other people because they've got a following. And that's all I'm going to do is just point it out to her. You got a following. You can help them. That's it. So that's what my inquiry is going to be. All right, now I know what you're saying. But what if they don't teach fitness? And what would I say to them to get them to want to call me back? Well, hey, Sam, I had a quick question about the program your company offers to their employees. Are you free tomorrow at noon for a quick call? Okay. They could be someone who works in health and wellness. They may need a health and wellness program. Fit Club would fit in perfectly
for challenge groups.
Mm-hmm. A challenge group, anything. So you are thinking about them because the programming the company offers or may not offer.
Right.
And you do have an option for them.
You're just asking a question. Okay, mm-hmm. Another one. Hey, Dan, I had a quick question about where your son takes karate. Are you free tomorrow at noon?
So I'm going to talk about karate. And I may even say, you know, my son's been going to this karate studio, and they actually have been helping their participants get ready for their next belt rank or competitions by doing fit clubs called Insanity. Because that's actually what's happening in my son's karate studio right now. Do you think that your karate studio might be interested in that too? You never know. So it's a way to get in. And I learned this technique back when we were working for Powder Blue Productions, Charlene's company. And I used to work training the presenters on how to effectively call directors and gym owners to get them interested in knowing about the trainings that we had coming up. And if I called a director and said, hey, Julie, we've got a training coming up and I want you to sign up all of your instructors to come so my event will go. What would she do? Will she call me back if I left her that message? No, because I'm just promoting to her. I'm just promoting for my benefit. That's it. But if I called her and said, hey, Julie, I have a quick question. I know you guys have some group exercise schedule. Can you give me a call? I have a question about your instructors. Oh, she might call me back because mm-hmm. it might be a problem. Mm-hmm. So that director may call me back because she's like, what's going on with my instructors? So you want to kind of draw something that may make them curious. So here we go. You want to know what you should be saying now when you're going to get them going on the call? Here we go. These are the 5 points. It's a secret sauce. You follow this. It's a roadmap. I need to preface this though, and I'm going to say it slowly. This is not a script. If you want to script your phone call and read or really just make this very scripty, you're not going to sign that person up. You're not going to get that challenge back. You're not going to get them interested at all. You don't like script yourself, so stop it. You don't like when someone says a script to you, so stop saying it. This has to be real. All I'm doing is I'm connecting with someone, and I have a path for my brain to not get derailed. That's it. Because too many times when people get nervous, their voice goes up, number one. But then they start like losing what they were going to say. And then they're like, oh my gosh, where do I tell them to go watch? I don't remember what I was going to say to this person. You get totally derailed. But if you can at least have 5 points in your head of knowing how the conversation should go, just follow it in this order, then you're going to have success by that call. Now here's some rules of what I, again, had my boot campers do when they made these calls. Say, now I've got Jody set up for noon to talk to her about Zumba. I then make these rules. The call should only be about 2 minutes for this part of the call. And you secondly want to tell them that you don't have time to be on the call. That sounds weird, doesn't it? But it takes a weight off of them on the other side, because then they know you're not going to be trapping them on a phone call. Okay? So these are the 5 points, and it's just the roadmap of what you're going to say when you get them on the call. And a lot of it's very simple. You've already known it, but now it's like, oh, yeah, there it is. Let me clearly put it in front of my brain. Now I'll do it, and it'll work. Identify why you're calling them. The second step is why you thought of them, give or the compliment to them. You teach Zumba, and you have a huge following, don't you? Don't you have a lot of people that take your class? Who doesn't like a compliment? Raise your hand if you don't like a compliment. Hello, there you go. Everyone loves a compliment. Point them to a presentation, or the Shakeology, or the Fit Club, whatever you want them to check out. You point them to the third-party tool. This fourth step is really important, and it's critical that you keep it in the fourth position of the conversation. Negate or disclaim it. It might not be for them, and it's okay. And the fifth part is you set the follow-ups. And that's it. That's the secret sauce of why all those coaches sign so many coaches. Crazy, isn't it? It's just so simple. It really is nothing. So how do you apply it? Julie and I want to share with you a live role call here, a role play here. All right, so our setup is, which is the truth. Julie, or partially the truth since she lives in Indiana, I live in Texas. But her daughter does dance. And her daughter's 14, you said? Mm-hmm. Okay, Josie is 14. And my daughter is Peyton, and she's 3. She just started dance. So our daughters go to the same dance studio. I know Julie. I know she's super fit. She likes to work out. And I know her daughter, Josie, teaches my daughter's class. So what I'm going to do is send Julie an email from the dance mom's email list and say, hey, Julie, I have a question about Josie and my daughter, Peyton, in dance class. Do you have a quick second to call me tomorrow, that I can call you tomorrow at noon? Now, what would you do if you got that email? Would you call me, or would I set up the call? Why would you think I would call her back? What's the subject of the inquiry?
Her business.
My child. Someone sent you an email, or a text, or a call, and inquiring about your child? Are you going to call them back? Heck yeah, I am. I want to know what's going on with my kid.
Yeah.
So definitely. Okay, so now, yeah, she set the appointment. She said, yeah, because she wants to know, is her daughter like doing bad things? Who knows? So I call her, and I started this way. Now, it's super important, again, that I let her know that I don't have much time to be on the call. So I'll call her and say, hey, Julie, it's Christine from the dance studio. I've only got 5 minutes before I got to take Peyton into a dentist appointment. Is this still a good time for you?
Yep, sure is.
Okay. I quick wanted to get in touch with you because I don't know if you know, but I actually teach group exercise. I'm big into fitness myself, and I actually help people with the company that makes P90X, Insanity, Turbo Fire. Have you ever seen those workouts or infomercials?
Yeah, you know, I think we might have P90X in the basement, but I'm not sure we've ever opened it.
Well, you know, I totally thought of you because, you know, Josie has been helping my daughter, Peyton, and Peyton just loves her to pieces, and that's why you just came to my mind because you are so fit, and you really are a great example and motivate so many other moms for your fitness. I think this is something you should check out, too, because you really can help a lot more people, especially these dance moms. Could you just watch a video about what this is, what I'm doing as well? It's a video presentation online. You can watch it whenever you want.
Sure. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll watch it.
It's on platinumpresenters.com, and if you just click on business presentation, it's there 24/7. But I just want to let you know, I'm okay if you don't think this is for you, because I know where you can really help a lot of people, and I think this is no risk for you to just check out, but I'm okay if you don't think it's for you. When do you think you'll watch the presentation?
You know, I think we might have some time tonight after I get back from picking Josie up. So I probably have a little bit of time tonight.
Okay, so do you think 100% you'll watch it tonight then?
Sure.
Okay, so if you watch it tonight, are you still free tomorrow for me to call you right back at like noon again for 5 minutes to check in and see what you thought?
Yeah, I think so. I think it'll be
okay.
Free.
All right, well, I'll talk with you tomorrow.
Sounds good.
That's it. So that goes for 2 minutes. Now that call, that part of the call would only be like 2 minutes. But if her and I were like long lost high school friends, I wouldn't just immediately jump into that. We might have a longer conversation. It might be a 30 minute call. But the only part of the business part of it all is this step, 2 minutes. So that's something to think about, is that you're not just going to crush everybody with, you know, just, you know, this point of system and then get off the call. You may, some people may want that, depending on what type of personality that they are. Mm-hmm. Okay, next step now. Here's your next action item. I'm going to teach you how to be a stalker.
What?
Now, poor PowerPoint animations. Came in too fast. Schedule it. You need to schedule your follow-ups. What if Julie responded with, well, I might have some time this weekend to watch it. Is that good enough for me? No. Because we don't know when this weekend is. So I won't accept that. I will actually say to her, well, when do you think? Do you think maybe like Saturday morning? When do you really think that you might watch it? Because I just don't want to, you know, keep trying to play phone tag with you. Say it aloud. So have her define, okay, Saturday morning, good, then I'll call you here. Don't let it be open to chance. Don't you ever say, go watch the presentation and then get it back to me. Holy cows, no. Okay? Next thing here is schedule the follow-up. You have to be firm on that schedule follow-up, just like I explained right here. So now your calendar is going to look like this. No, you're not F-U-ing Joey either. Poor Jody, Mike, and Susan. No, those are your follow-ups. Right? Because you have the appointments to call, and now your calendar's going to have your scheduled follow-ups, too. You can't forget that. You need to put that on. It's the critical point of this process. Schedule, and in the follow-up, seriously, why are you scared about it? I used to be really scared about it. Like, I just wouldn't do it, because I was always like, I don't want to actually talk on the phone. Like, I just prefer to email. I just don't know what they'll say. You know what? You want to know, don't you? Be fine with it if it's not right for someone. It's okay. Don't try to convince someone to do this business, because if you're trying to convince them to do this business, when they sign up, you're going to convince them to do this business. Mm-hmm. So, be okay with it. Close the door. If it's not okay for them, then fine. I'm okay with it. It's fine. It gives you peace of mind. It lets you cross them off your list. You know where they stand, right?
Yeah, the business isn't right for everyone. We have to know that. I mean, we are so passionate about what we do. We love what we do so much that sometimes it's easy to assume everyone else is as passionate about it. So it's kind of like your dog or your kid, like you talk about it, like everyone else loves it as much as you do. And quite honestly, they don't. We in this room are the people who, when Tony or Shalene or Brett or Sean says, and the workout's going to go an extra hour today, we go, yes! That is awesome! Unless not everyone does that. We are a rarer breed. We are positive. We are passionate. We are service-oriented. We lead with our hearts. We love what we do. Not everyone out there is like that. And we have to be okay that even though we think the business is for everyone, because really it is, but even if we think that, they might not think that. And we've got to get so okay with them not liking it. Remember when Craig would talk to us about ordering something, you know, coffee? Do you want coffee at the restaurant? And we would say no. Does the waitress run off and go, it's so terrible because you turned down the offer of coffee? No, she still comes back to her job. It's okay if they are not ready to be a part of the business. It could be a not yet.
Right.
Could be a not yet, but get okay with that because you're confident enough in this business. You're confident enough in what we have to offer that if they say no, it's okay because there's so many other people out there that need what we have.
So now it's time to follow up. So now the critical time. You have to be prompt on your time. Be respectful of their time as well. So when I would call her back, when I would call Julie back, when I called Jody back, the first things that I would ask them is this still an okay time?
Honor their time. When you honor their time, you honor them. So show that you're honoring their time and that little bit of time that they're willing to give to you that day.
Yeah, because I don't know that if I just called you at noon and right before you're picking up the phone, her daughter smashes into a door and bloody noses everywhere, right? That kind of stuff happens. And like, do you ever have like a phone call that came in and you're in the middle of like picking up poopy diapers or something? Like it was all over the place. I've had diarrhea swings and babies and stuff. Crazy stuff happens. But you want to make sure that they are still okay to be on the phone call. Mm-hmm. And the next thing is ask if they watched the presentation or tasted the shake or did what you asked them to do. Ask them, did you? So this is how the call's going to go. Hey, is this me? Is this still okay time? Did you get a chance to do? Okay. Yeah? And now this is the next critical part of a follow-up. Tie the reason of interest back in. So if you just said, so what'd you think?
Like, hope, please. Right, sign up. Yes.
No, because most of the time we live in a very negative world. Even though you guys are super positive and happy and walk around with smiles on your face all the time. But not everybody does, right? So you have to paint the picture of positivity back into them. Or paint that compliment of why you thought of them back into here. Mm-hmm. So if I said, did you watch the presentation? And they said yes. And say, see, don't you see how you've already been helping so many of the moms at the dance studio? And that you can really help a lot more people by using this as a vehicle? That's all this is. This is a vehicle. I'm not a Beachbody coach working for Beachbody. No, I don't. I work for myself. I'm a brand. I attract people to me so I can help them in any way that they need. Whatever service I offer in that way. I'm not just going to sell them Shakeology. So that's what you want to think about, is you paint that picture of, this is a way for you to help more people. You obviously love fitness. I'm sure you get a lot of questions. Don't you think it would be cool for you to be able to set up like a dance fit club mom thing? You know, whatever. Paint it back in. Because now you got their mind thinking in a positive way of how they can actually do it. Mm-hmm. And then we move into closing the call. How many of you have kids? Okay, young kids? Really young? Okay, how many of you, if you sent them up to their room to get dressed, they would come out with an awesome outfit? Okay. All right, or like my three-year-old. Basically, the best thing that we do is give her two choices. Because if I give her two choices, I know at least I win. Right? Same thing with your phone calls. Give them two choices. Lead it in the positive. Do you want me to stay on the phone now? We can just sign up right now and get you at least signed up. And then we can schedule how you get your started. You're getting started right later. So do you want to do it now? Or do you want to schedule a time for me to do it with you later? There's two choices. Do you want to do it now? Or do you want to sign up tonight when the kids go to bed and then email me right after as soon as you're done signing up? That's another choice. You're giving them two choices. Mm-hmm. And the other thing that you really want to focus on is nailing security for them in training. Mm-hmm. Because too many times people that join a business that's network marketing get really scared that they're going to get deserted. Mm-hmm. Like many of you have been when you signed up and you don't have much support from your coach. Mm-hmm. Because you didn't know you should select the coach that you want to be with. Or you just randomly signed up. Or you chose poorly. One of the others, right? But we can't make everybody want to do this on their own time. So it's not a negative against your coach. It's just not their thing right now. It's not them.
And there's so much security in knowing that you have a support system. That there is a large team and not just the Team Beachbody back office, which is flipping phenomenal. But that there is a support system in the team that whether they want to engage right now or they want to engage a little bit later, you are there for them. That team is there for them whenever that engagement happens. There's a huge amount of security in knowing that whatever their questions are, you're there to support them.
You're just going to let them know, okay, as soon as you get signed up, what I'm going to do is I'm going to send you an email that tells you exactly what you should do in your setup, and then we're going to schedule a phone call. So you let them know right away. You've already got their next plan of action ready to go because now they feel good. Like, okay, I'm not going to be deserted. So we've only got 5 minutes to get through. We're going to talk a little bit about communication with confidence.
We have 5 minutes.
5 minutes. Woo!
Okay. Go flip the slide to the next one, to first impressions, and get that stuff up there.
I'll do the first impressions part.
Yeah, do it.
So the part where we feel that your most success is going to come is not by knowing what steps to do, because you've got a game plan, you've got the Coach Training Academy, you now have this 5-step exposure, you have Tommy Migrant's 5-step challenge process, you've got systems. Where the difference is your communications with people. If you can improve your conversations with people and understand how to connect more in that conversation one-on-one, you're going to have greater results in relationships with people. The first thing that we're going to be talking about is the first impressions. If I just met Julie right now, I would already have an idea of her in the first 3 seconds if I liked her or not. 50% of first impressions are based on how you put yourself together. Wow, 50%? That's a lot.
It is a lot. Mm-hmm. So wear and share is so important.
too.
It is. Mm-hmm. As well as when you do, do you ever run out to the grocery store like late at night because you just need that one item and you're like, oh, no, it's going to be there, and you're all like mess? Yes.
You always
that person's always
know.
There?
You always, always
and you're like,
you know.
Oh, I have no makeup on. I got crazy hair. Like, 50% is based on that. Guess what the other bulk of the first impression is based on? Is it what you say? Is it what you say? Is it what you say? No. It's the sound of your voice. The sound of your voice. Not what you say, the sound of your voice. So 90% of your encounter with someone has nothing to do with what you're going to say. Wow. So do you see how it's no big deal now on what you're saying? And if you just keep it simple, like we just pointed out, you're going to be more effective because the last 10% is what you say.
Mm-hmm. Small talk is just making conversation. Carl asked the other day, how's life? Ask people, how their children? How's that new car you were looking at? How's your new home? How's your life doing? Because your intent is to serve, not to sell. Ask them how their life is. Find out how they are. Find out what their story is so that you can build a relationship, which equals trust. And then you can find a path where you can help them. And as we talked about earlier, personality talks, listening and paying attention to those cues that they're giving you that let you know what kind of personality they have so that you can better communicate with them. Always keeping that in your radar when you're talking with someone so that, that what you say does come across the way it needs to. And then last is the follow-up.
And setting up the follow-up. The follow-up relates to, it doesn't always have to be about Beachbody. In all of your communications and so and when you socialize with people, just try to always set like another reason why to stay in touch with that person. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't always have to be anything about Beachbody. It could be something totally relative of, hey, when you go to the gym and you take that new hula hoop class, can you come back and let me know how it was? Mm-hmm. Or, hey, when you make that salmon for dinner, can you tell me how you made it? Some way of staying in connection. Or when I get back on vacation, I wanted to get back in touch with you to help me with my landscaping. Whatever it is. Find a way to connect and ask them questions to always come back in touch with you by a common ground, asking for their opinion. So when if you took Janelle's training yesterday, that is one big thing that when you put a post out there, people love to give their two cents, don't they? So your posts are asking for opinion, asking for help, asking for advice is always what people love to give. They do. Even if you know it, even if you think you're perfect, who cares? Ask it. Because you're going to get a greater response out of that. And you set the appointments, be consistent, and do it regularly. And you have to be consistent. If you aren't, this is not going to work.
How many of you had to juggle some things in your life to get here this weekend? Some childcare, some jobs? You are rock stars already. You are rock stars already. This system just gives you another tool in your toolbox. You came here, you juggled a lot of stuff, you got here this weekend, and you've taken lots of nuggets and information. This system that you can take back with you and share with your team, and it's all part of the tools in your toolbox. Yesterday I took Brett Hobel's workouts, and he said, energy is contagious, and passion is priceless. Energy is contagious and passion is priceless. Use these tools. Use this system to ignite your energy and go home and be contagious with people. Share your passion because we have something that's so amazing. Share your passion with them and use this system to help you feel more confident to do that.
We really value, again, that this is what you're going to really focus on, is building relationships, lifting people, making them feel like they can do something, even if it's a small, minute level of success. Because your coaches aren't going to get to 15 star in a couple months. They're not. It's going to take a lot of little steps. If you can break it down and say, what can I do just this week that they're going to feel a little bit of success, they're going to grow and want to do more. So unload your homework for your coaches and just give them a small amount of step that they can do because you're that person that's going to keep lifting them. Always be inspirational, telling them what they can do and always what can work better, not what didn't they do. Because when they can, you can speak positively to your team, they're going to connect with you so much more. I really appreciate you guys giving us your time. I want to thank my best friend here.